We were up long before the day, oh, to welcome in the summer, to welcome in the May, oh, for summer is a coming in and winter's gone away, oh.
There were three men that came out of the west, the fortunes for to try, and these three men made a solemn oath, John Barleycorn should die. They found a salt, they arrowed him in, drunk clones all on his end. Then these three men made a solemn vow, John Barleycorn was dead. They let him alive time, till the rain from heaven did fall. The little Sir Johnny raised up his head, he soon amazed them all. They let him alight through the long midsummer, till he looked both pale and wan. The little Sir Johnny grown a long, long beard, and he soon became a man.
Spell, I am going
to enter Tintagel. Oh, wizard, come and change my face to that on the Duke Cornwall. Then I can enter through the gates and Tintagel will fall.
Tell him to make
Stein. It grew on a stone. It resists poison. It fights pain. This is the herb that strove against the snake. This has strength against the foe who fares through the land.
From this crippled boy. Yes, the questions came from left and right. Why did he cause the lightning strike? Come, come, repent, you will be saved. Well, at least you'll have a Christian grave. So he pricked his body and he cried until he felt no more and he was still. That proves his guilt now, don't you see? The priest said with solemnity.
so they took him out to an open place. There a mound of wood they raised, they placed him up on top so high, then they gave him a drink lest he shouldn't die. And next they brought a burning brand, and the priest then gave the last command. This fire will save your immortal soul. As Thomas died, this was he told.
Thank you. this night with me. Well, to spend this night with you, he said, would cost no end of war. For I know you to be Lord Pan as the wife by the golden ring you wear. Oh, what if I am Lord Pan as the wife? Lord Banner is not at home, for he has gone to London town to fetch young Henry's throne. Now by their stone a little foot paid, and he took to his heels and run. And he run till he came to the water side, when he bent his breast and swum. What news do you bring, my little foot paid? Is me castle burning down, or is me lady brought to bed of a daughter or a son? No, your castle is not burning down, nor have you a daughter and son. Little magic robe is a bed with your wife, and they do lie as one. Well, they haven't been in bed for an hour or more, nor yet fell fast asleep, when up there stepped Lord Banner himself, and he stood at their bed feet. Oh, how do you like me blankets, sir? How do you like me sheets? And how do you like me pulse, young wife, that lies in your arms asleep? Right well do I like your blankets, sir. Right well do I like your sheets. Oh, but better do I like your gay young wife that lies in my arms asleep. So arise and dress, little Matty Crow, fast as there you can. It shall never be said in the morning sun that I slew an aged man. Now Matty had the very first blow, and he struck and he hit the floor. Lord Banner had the second blow, and Matty struck no more. So he took his lady by the hand, set her on his knee. Come, tell me which you love the best, little Matty Crow, for me. Right well do I like your cheek, she said. Right well do I like your chin. Oh, but better do I like little Matty Crow than you and all your kin. So he took his lady by the hand, led her to the hall, and cutting off her head with his good broadsword, he kicked it against the wall. Go bury these lovers in one grave, bury them up within. Oh, but lay me lady at the top, for she's of no merkin. Come fetch me down, me walking cane, for I'm up to see me dog.